Hi, this is the sixth recording in a series of recordings dealing with the basics of Christianity that we wanted to give you just to help you grow and get started in your Christian walk. If you came so far, if you're listening to this video, I really want to congratulate and commend you for keeping on, for enduring, and for taking this seriously. If you skipped over the others and came to this video, it is fine, but please go back and listen to the other recordings as well. Now, today I want to talk to you about the Holy Spirit, and in one sense, we kept the best for last. You see, the truth is that we need the Holy Spirit for anything. Whether we are praying, we need the Holy Spirit. If we are reading our Bibles, we need the Holy Spirit to interpret that for us and to minister that for us. If we want to be part of a local church, we need the Holy Spirit to guide us and to weave us into the body of Christ. You see, the reality is that you can't even make a decision to serve God if it isn't for the Holy Spirit. That is how important He is. Now, I was privileged growing up in a Christian home, but more than that, I gave my heart to God at a very early stage in my life, and I was baptized with the Holy Spirit when I was 11 years old. So I grew up with the knowledge of the Holy Spirit. Unfortunately, many of us don't, and we need teaching about the Holy Spirit. So today's video is a short introduction. I want to introduce you to the Holy Spirit. To start off, I will ask the question, who is the Holy Spirit? Notice that I said who. Firstly, He is not a force or an influence. Some people may think that He's a wind or a fire or a dove. And though the Bible does use symbols like that to describe the person and the work of the Holy Spirit, it says He is like a dove and like fire and like wind, but He is not a force. He is a person. Now, you know, a person has a character, has personality, has emotions. We can please the Holy Spirit or we can grieve the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a person, but more than that, the Holy Spirit is God. He is part of the Godhead. We have God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. That is what we as Christians believe in. Now, it is not only important to know about the Holy Spirit, but we need to know Him because He is God. Let me read from John 14. And I will ask the Father, and He will give you another helper, the Counselor who will be with you forever, the Spirit of Truth. The world cannot accept Him because it neither sees Him nor knows Him, but you know Him, for He lives in you and He will be with you. Isn't that amazing? Jesus spoke these words of the Holy Spirit while He was still on earth, but He knew that He was going away, that He will be going to heaven to prepare a place for you and me who believe. And He says that I will not leave you alone as orphans. He will not reject us. He will not leave us alone, but He gives us another helper that He calls the Counselor. And you know what He says? That it is better for Him to go away because then this helper will come. Now, I have very good news for you, my friend. The moment you gave your heart to God, you received the Holy Spirit. He lives in you. He dwells in you. He has made you alive. And when you are sitting there and you know that you have given your heart to God, you can have this assurance that the Holy Spirit lives in you. Now, why did Jesus say it is better that He will go and that the Holy Spirit will come? Well, we know from the Bible that the Holy Spirit will live with us, as we just said. He will make His home with us, which means you never have to be alone. God's indwelling presence is with you always. Secondly, He will teach us and He will guide us into all truth. The Holy Spirit is the source of all wisdom. When you don't have wisdom, if you don't know what to do next, He will help you, He will guide you, He will also teach you more about God. He will guide you, like we just said. He will guide you to know God better, to know God's will for your life. If you have a situation that you don't know, should you choose A or B, C or D, the Holy Spirit will guide you and He will govern you if you submit your life under Him. Lastly, He will convict the world of sin. It is important that the Holy Spirit tells us when we're not pleasing God, when there is sin in our lives, that we may respond and that we may repent. Isn't that a wonderful thought? But you know, I don't know if you've ever seen one of those TV adverts where the marketer says, but wait, there's more. Well, in this case, I can assure you that there is really more. Because besides the Holy Spirit coming to live with us, God promises us that He will baptize us in the Holy Spirit. Now, this is something a little bit different. We receive the Holy Spirit when we give our lives to God, but we get baptized with His Spirit at another point in time. Acts 1 verse 8 says, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. So when we receive the Holy Spirit, or the baptism of the Holy Spirit, we receive power. Power to do what exactly, you may ask? It is power to be God's witnesses, or to put it a little bit differently, to be the light in a very dark world and to lead other people and to introduce other people to the true light. So you see, friends, we are only starting out. You are only starting out in this journey in your work with God. There is so much more to be discovered. But the thing is, you can't do it alone. You need the Holy Spirit. And I want to conclude this by just praying a prayer over you, if that is fine. I pray that you will welcome the Holy Spirit in your life. I pray that He will comfort you when you are alone. I pray that He will help you when you feel weak. I pray that He will give you wisdom when you don't know where to go next, and that He will govern and guide you as you navigate your life. I pray that you will open your heart, that you may receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, so that you may walk in the power to be God's witness. I want to pray that you will open your heart to God, that He may baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with power, that you may be His witness. And lastly, I pray that you will wait on Him, that He will continually fill you. Bless you.